Brigantia Blackbird, a Blackbird's Brew. Happy Wednesday and welcome back to our series on the Havamal. This week we are looking at verse 68 and examining three different translations. The first reads, "Most dear is fire to the sons of men, most sweet the sight of the sun. Good is health if one can but keep it, and to live a life without shame." Olive Bray. Second translation, "These things are thought the best, fire, the sight of the sun, good health with the gift to keep it, and a life that avoids vice." That's W.H. Auden and P.P. Taylor. And now for our last translation from the Cowboy Havamal. "A warm home is good for you. The sunshine is good for you, and your health too, of course. But don't underestimate how good it is to live without things to say sorry for." And that is Dr. Jackson Crawford. So, fire, sunlight, good health, and a clear conscience are presented to us as keys to a meaningful and fulfilled life in this particular verse. Fire, of course, is absolutely essential in one form or another. We use it for everything. Keeping warm in winter, cooking, and all forms of motive power involve fire, at least in some sense of the term. This is true however simple or sophisticated a society is or how one's mean of living is. Sunlight, without which life on this planet would not exist, quite literally. Many people actually routinely experience depression if they experience a lack of sunlight over a prolonged period of time. We need the sun not only to exist, but to feel well. And speaking of wellness, good health is beyond price, and not just health of the body, but health of the mind, heart, and the spirit. And then we have an untroubled conscience, or as the verse puts it, a life without shame, or a life that avoids vice, or life without having things to say sorry for. That's also a very necessary component. Because what is more crippling than being fractured within your soul because your conscience feels guilty and it's constantly bringing that guilt to your attention? Wrongdoing does take a toll. And even if a person manages to dull their conscience or contrive a way to become deaf to its nagging, the idea of getting away with something is quite an illusion. There's always a price to pay, even if other people aren't aware of that price. We will still experience it in some fashion. What's more, vice manifests in our behavior, and that's easily seen by the people around us, even if we bully them into pretending, at least around us, that our bad behavior or our poor character traits aren't actually a problem. Of course they are, and they know that, even if we frighten them into not saying so. And that has an effect on the kind of caliber of the people we have around us. Perhaps they are equally corrupt as we are in that state, or perhaps they are just extremely weak and easily bullied. We're just not going to have as good of a life or as favorable of outcomes, and certainly not particularly good company, if we tolerate a lack of virtue within ourselves and if we associate with people who also tolerate that lack of virtue. Because even if people don't punish us for our misdeeds, we cannot escape the consequences of our actions. Eventually we will pay, and we will long to go back in time to make different choices and then have a life in which there's no cause for shame. So something to think about here, and also quite a refutation for people who might make the argument that paganism is just hedonistic, or that there's no moral standards, or that nothing is ever expected of you. Lots to think about here. But that's what I think of this verse. Time to let me know what you think of it. Tell me all about it in the comment section below, or come pay me and the rest of the group on Gilded a little visit. Our server is named Blackbird's Brew. There's a link to join us in the description box, and you'd be very welcome there. But that'll do it for now, and I will see you next time. Bye.